Changemaker, Holly Rustick here with Grant Writing and Funding, and I'm here to help you grow capacity, increase funding, and to advance mission. And that might be the mission of the nonprofit that you work at currently, or maybe the missions of many nonprofits that you work with if you're a freelance grant consultant, or if you're a consultant in the nonprofit world and you're looking to get better grant writing skills. All right, so today we're going to answer a question, and it's a question I actually get quite a bit from clients or clients to be, but also other people that are listening to the podcast, or, you know, reading the book, looking at courses, those sort of things. And they email this question to me, and it's kind of twofold, but it's basically, okay, Holly, how do I get paid as a grant writer, especially if the nonprofit does not have any funding right currently? And can I get a commission? Can I write a grant based on a commission? So basically that means they write the grant, they only get paid if it gets awarded, and they get a certain percentage of the grant that gets awarded. Now, here's the thing, two things. No, you can't do that, all right? So the first thing is, yes, you can figure out ways for a nonprofit to pay you as a grant writer. You should not just volunteer your time all the time, especially if this is your main work, right? This is what you're doing for work. You're writing grants. It is an expertise. It is a skill. It is like anything else, you know, so you should get paid for your time, whether or not the grant gets awarded. Two, it's against best practices. So federal grants, foundation grants, they don't necessarily allow you to pay for anything that was done pre-award. And obviously the writing the grant, it's not awarded yet, so that is considered pre-award. All right, so grants are very finicky in particular. So everything that you write in the budget, personnel, fringe benefits, equipment, supplies, all of that, it is allocated, right? You already have, like, this is the project I'm going to do, and this is how much I'm going to spend in each category. So those are the monies that they're going to give you. And a lot of times you have to give receipts, you have to give program reports, all of those things, fiscal reports. And that doesn't account for any work that was done pre-grant, okay? So that's the thing. So it is against best practices. But the second thing you do, and this is kind of a conversation that you really need to learn how to have with nonprofits, right? To educate them, because they just don't know. So they're just going to say, you can just get a commission. Can we just do it that way? So you kind of have to come back and say, well, it's against best practices for the reasons that I just listed. The second thing that you can really say, and what this really resonates with people as soon as you explain it, then they're kind of like, oh, okay, I totally get it, is you are creating a product when you write a grant. All right, so whether or not it gets awarded, it can be repurposed. And what do I mean by this? Well, for one thing, if you get feedback on the grant, say if it wasn't awarded, follow up with the funding source and ask for feedback, okay? So you can say, why wasn't awarded? And they'll tell you. They have to review it. So they're going to have reasons why it wasn't awarded. And that way you can go ahead, and if you want to resubmit, you're like, this is still a great grant. We want to go after it again, right? This is a great opportunity for us. It fits. It's aligned. Everything. Take the feedback that you got. Make your grant better, more competitive. Actually implement what the feedback was, the comments, all of that, so you can resubmit when the next cycle is open for that funding period. So the grant might reopen the next year or in 6 months, that sort of thing, so resubmit, okay? So then you'll have a stronger grant application. And a lot of times, especially foundations, they will just say no the first like two or three times that they see you submit, even if it's fantastic. Why? They want to see that you have staying power, right? So many nonprofits start up and they fizzle out. They dissolve like that, right? So they want to make sure that you're serious, you have skin in the game, you're going to stick around, and they will say no sometimes 2 or 3 years. So it's just one of those things that you just got to put in, right? Keep going. All right, so that's the thing. So you are creating a product. So the three things that you can do with that product that you can tell the nonprofit, right, is one, like I just said, you can reuse the grant, submit again for next year, take the feedback, implement it, submit again. The second thing you can do is you can take that same grant and you can look at other funding sources that are very similar in their priorities and what your project, if that's a great project, it would also fit those priorities, and you can kind of change the language, tweak it a little bit just to fit those other funding sources, and you can apply to those. Now make sure they are a good fit for that specific grant application. All right. So the third thing you can do, and this is kind of like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, but What you can do with that is you can repurpose your grant application for other things. One easy thing you can do is update your website. Now, the thing is, when you're writing a grant, you're doing statistics, you're doing all these updated statistics on the need. You're also just realigning your messaging, you're making sure you have an evaluation plan, you're actually seeing what your budget's supposed to be, you're making a timeline, putting objectives and goals in place, evaluations, data collection, all of these things. There's a lot of work that can go into a grant application, but it's not for naught. What does that mean? You can repurpose. You can pull up that information, update your website with all the research that you did, the statistics, you know, everything that you did for that. That's one way you can repurpose it. Another way you can repurpose it is that you can actually use it for maybe a crowdfunding campaign. You're like, that grant, that funding source said no, but we still want this project to go forward. We still want it to work, right? So we are going to go after other funding sources, maybe not grants, but maybe we're going to do a crowdfunding campaign because this is a great, great project and we can still use the same messaging. We can use the same stats. We can use the same timeline, objectives, all of those things for a crowdfunding campaign, right? Or maybe for a solicitation letter for corporate sponsors, or for a fundraiser. So it's not for naught, right? You can definitely repurpose this product. So remember, it is a product. You still put your time and energy into it as a grant writer, so you should be paid for your time. You should not get kickbacks or bonuses if it's awarded. You should pay what your value really is, whether or not it's awarded, because it is a product. All right, so Holly, how can they pay me though, right? You're saying I can charge and I have good evidence to back it up of why I want to be paid and why I should be paid, but how can they do it? What if they just don't have any funding? Okay, here are three ways that a nonprofit with maybe no funding at this point in time for grant writer can actually get some money to pay you. One easy one, do a fundraiser. They can definitely do a fundraiser to pay for your services. And it's like any other services, like advertising, any other expertise service, I should say, a lawyer, accounting, all of that. They wanna have this service, even social media expert. Maybe they really like, man, that's what we need to have. So what do they do to pay for them? They might do fundraising, right? Maybe they do some car washes, bake sales. You know, they can do small scale stuff. It doesn't all have to be like galas or like these huge events. They can do something pretty small to really bring in the money, you know, so they can do something like that. So number one is fundraising. Number two, if they have any products or services that they already sell, those monies are now going into the general operating funds. So they can use general operating funds. I'm not saying grant specific funds, because remember, we already talked about those are allocated for certain things, but I'm talking about general operating funds. They can definitely use that. So maybe they have a cafe, maybe they have a childcare center where they're getting monies that, you know, come in through that. Maybe they have a thrift store. So if they have any kind of products or services, even like the services, so you're like, what kind of services would that be? That could be if they have their counselors and they do services, maybe some of the counselors, you know, they volunteer their time, right? So then that those monies that come in that people pay go into the general operating budget. So you can definitely do things like that, products or services. And I definitely recommend nonprofits to do products and services because you want to have a variety and a diversification of funding coming into your nonprofit. You don't want it just all on grants. Grants are project specific. They don't have the general operating capabilities all the time, right? So you really want to have other things going on. And just the same, you don't only want to have products and services. You also want to go after grants and different types of crowdfunding and corporates, all of these. You want to have a diversification, right? That's a healthy nonprofit. Okay, so what else can they do? They can also, they can also use indirect cost rates. So if you have an indirect cost rate, and we can definitely, there's a, I think episode 36 in the podcast definitely goes over that step by step, what that all means. But basically, they can ask for a certain amount indirect. So a nonprofit has an indirect cost rate, and that can include paying for development. Now, indirect cost is basically what it means. It's indirect. They don't have direct program expenses. It's the indirect. It might be the rent, the utilities, the internet, the cost of the executive director, the accountant. It's kind of those things that are kind of, they're just indirect, right? So under that, you could have a development person, and that person could be a grant writer, right? So that's one way that you can do that. And you can charge up to 10% of any grant for that indirect budget, okay? So you can't really pay for the indirect for the grant they wrote before, but maybe they're working on grants in the meantime and helping develop the projects. There you go. You can use that. Now, once the grant gets awarded, this is kind of a plus one, okay? Once the grant gets awarded, you can then maybe have the grant writer, they want them to come on in another position, and they can help fund you doing another position. Now, they wouldn't be paying you through that, through the grant that you wrote, but maybe you're now a project coordinator or a campaign developer, that sort of thing that was already written in the grant and that can pay you for doing that service for the project. That makes sense. Okay, so those are different ways. Once again, let's just recap real quick. So you should get paid. You should not get paid through commission, though, as a grant writer, because it is against best practices. All right, but you should be paid because you are creating a product. All right, so how can that nonprofit pay for your services? They can do fundraising. They can create products and services or use those monies raised from the products and services. They can use indirect costs, right? Okay, and what can you really say about the grant? What is that product? If it doesn't get awarded, what can they do with it? Well, they can reuse it and they can resubmit for the next time that funding source is open by implementing the feedback. Number two, they can submit to other grants that are very similar, that have similar priorities. Number three, they can repurpose that product. It is a product. It is a huge product that you worked on. So you should not be doing it just for free, right? It is your time. It's your energy. It can be reused. They can use it on their website, crowdfunding campaigns, solicitation letters, even press releases. There's so many different things that they can do with that product that you created. All right, I hope this helps you guys. And if you have any questions, please let me know, Holly at grantwritingandfunding.com. All right, you guys keep getting funding. All right.